We have two times in Python, and you'd like to know how much time has elapsed between them. Sure, it's easy to say how many seconds have gone by, but what about minutes or hours or days or weeks? This seems so frustrating and underdeveloped in Python. In fact, there's an easy way to answer that question. It is just incredibly non-obvious. And I'm so excited to share this with you because after this short video, you will not look at time in Python the same way. Hey, I'm Michael Kennedy, and I'm bringing you short tips on Python in this Python short series. If you want to learn a bunch of cool things about Python in just a few minutes, be sure to hit the subscribe button down below. In this video, we're talking about time, specifically working with time ranges between two times in Python. Getting times is easy. We can say T0 equals daytime.now or some time later, we've done some work. We want to know how much time has elapsed. T1 equals datetime.now. Well, those are the two times. How about working on the difference? Of course, you're going to say it's easy. This is Python. You just subtract them. DT equals T1 minus T0. Boom, done. You have this thing called a time delta, and it tells you how much time is between those. Except getting information out of that DT object is super painful. It has a total seconds. That's great. But what if you want to express that gap of time in something other than seconds? All right, let's see. There's 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in an hour, 24 hours in a day. So we're going to take that and divide by 60, then divide by 60, then divide by 24. No, that's not actually how we're going to do it. Is there a DT.hours? No. A DT.days? No. A DT.weeks? No. This seems like a big omission, but we'll see in this video that you can actually compute these things quite easily. Here we are in PyCharm. Let's fire it up. So I've got this simple little application called Duration App, and its job is to give us just two times, and we're supposed to figure out how long in between them. In this scenario, imagine we're an artist, like a musician or something, and we want to know when we're arriving at a location and when we actually have to be on stage and perform. Do we have just a few hours to race from the airport? Or can we do things like go on vacation and relax for a few days, get over the jet lag, and then go do our performance? So we've got this simple little application, get event time, and it returns a date time here, date time object. And we are getting the performance time and the arrival time. It's super easy to figure out what the difference between those is. We just subtract them. Python is easy. And we're just going to print out, great, we're on stage in some number of seconds. How much time do we have? Well, we have 1,337,340 seconds. That seems like a lot. Is that days, weeks, years? I don't know. We got to do math, right? That's what you probably have been doing. You're like, okay, well, we're going to say days, total seconds, divided by 60, divided by 60, divided by 24. And then we could put days here, right? Let's see, put days. Look, oh, it's 15.4 days. Great. This is what I think a lot of people are doing. This is not the right way. Python has a very interesting, but completely non-obvious way to figure this out. Did you know you can divide time deltas by other time deltas? I'll see what I mean. Let's suppose I want to know the number of days. We could come over here and take our block of time and say, I would like that expressed as the number of days. Say date time dot time delta, and then days equals one. And let's go down here and say this is days. Look at that. This number right here is the same that we got with our complicated math where we said divide by 60, divide by 60, divide by 24. But this could be arbitrary time segments. What if we wanted to know the number of weeks? We'll come over here and we'll divide by days equals 7. So let's say in like that. Well, now we've got a little bit of a problem because we got 2 weeks and 15 days. So that's a little bit odd. And also notice those were exact ratios. So let's turn those into integers first. And now we've got 2 weeks, 15 days. Very close. but we're truncating this, and that's going to leave us, we want something between 0 and 6 days. So we can just do mod 7. There's not quite an exact way, whoops, on the days. We don't have an exact way to say, give me the days without the weeks. But we can express our time in arbitrary units of measurement. We could say 6 days, 4 hours, 10 minutes. How many blocks of those have happened during this time delta? Pretty awesome. Let's see what we got now. Look at that. We're on stage in 2 weeks and 1 day. Let's just tighten that up a little. Of course, you'd put a little logic for that. Way better than trying to juggle date time dot total seconds. We just divide by the block of time that we're interested in. How many days in a time delta? You divide by time delta, days equals 1. How many weeks? Divide by time delta equals 7 days. Fantastic. So if you find yourself trying to do math on the number of seconds, now we can start dividing by time deltas. And let me ask you, maybe you could comment down below, did you know that this was possible? Does this seem obvious to you? I worked on Python for many years before I learned that you could actually divide by a time delta of arbitrary size to get information like days, weeks, hours, and so on. It's incredibly easy, it's incredibly useful, but it is absolutely not obvious. But it's obvious to you now because you've seen it in action. There you have it. Working with time and time ranges in Python just got way better, didn't it? If you want a bunch of awesome tips like this, be sure to subscribe and like this video and get all the new Python shorts I'll be releasing here on the channel. Thanks so much. See you next time.